Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up questions 1 to 4 of class 5 Aryabhatta paper 2017 part 2. So let's look at the first question. Look at this given figure carefully and answer the following question. The minimum number of lines needed to make this figure is, so we need to find out the minimum number of lines that are needed to make this figure. So let's first of all start with the horizontal lines. So we see this is the line 1 and this is the line 2. So we have two horizontal lines. Let's look at the vertical lines. So we have this V1. We have this, which is V2, and this is the third one, which is V3. So we have three vertical lines. Now let's look at the slanting lines of this type. So we have this, which is the first one, this complete line, which is the second one, this is the third, and this is the fourth slanting line of this nature. So we have slanting lines of this type, let's call it S1. These are four, and let's look at the slanting lines S2, which are of this inclination. So let's count those. So we have this is the one, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. So we have four of this type of slanting lines. So these are the only four type of lines that we have in this figure. So that makes it minimum lines required are 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4, that gives us 13 lines. So we need minimum of 13 lines to make this figure. Moving on to the second question. The largest possible length of a rectangle whose area is equal to the area of a square with perimeter 36 centimeter. So we have a square whose perimeter is given to be 36 centimeter. So we know this is given by, if A is the side of the square, perimeter is given by 4A. So we can say the side of the square is 9 centimeter. So let's now find out its area. This is A square, so this is 91 centimeter square. Now, if this is the area of the rectangle, we know area of rectangle is equal to its length multiplied by the breadth, and that is given to be 81 centimeter square. Now, for the length to be largest, this implies that the breadth has to be minimum. So, if we take breadth as 1 centimeter, the length will come out to be the maximum, which is 81 centimeter. So, this is the largest possible length of a rectangle whose area is equal to the area of a square with perimeter 36 centimeter. Moving on to the next question. The difference between angle X and angle Y in triangle XYZ is 68 degree. And angle Z is twice of angle X. We need to find the three angles. So we know that, let's take angle X to be A. Angle Y we know is A plus 68, because the difference between the two is 68. And angle Z is twice of X, so we can say it is 2A. Now we know the sum of All the angles of the triangle is 180 degrees. So we can say A plus A plus 68 plus 2A is equal to 180 degree, which means 4A plus 68 is equal to 180. That gives us 4A equal to 112 and A equal to 28 degree. So we can say angle X is equal to 28 degree. Angle Y will be equal to 28 plus 68, which is 96 degree. And angle Z, which is 2A, will become 56 degree. So moving to the last question of the session, the distance between the center and any point on the boundary of a circle with a perimeter of 8,33,624 mm is, so if you're talking about a circle, the distance between the center and any point on the boundary of the circle is nothing but the radius of the circle. And we know the perimeter is given by 2 pi r, and that is given to be 8,33,624 mm. So if we put pi equal to 22 by 7 into r is equal to 8,33,624. So r is, if we just cross multiply, we get 8,33,624 into 7 divided by 2 into 22. Simplifying this, we get r is equal to 132,622 mm. So this is the distance between the center and any point on the boundary of a circle. So you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel for getting updates on the new sessions.